According to the Electoral Commission, the early release of a roadmap for the 2025-2026 general elections is meant to provide a clear communication and priority areas in the electoral cycle with an aim of improving operational efficiency. Speaking during the launch of the roadmap, the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, Justice Simon Byabakama Mujeni, explained that over 1.3 trillion shillings is needed this time round to organize these elections, which figure is much higher compared to the money which was used in the 2021 elections. He noted that the increase in the funds needed is driven by the increase in the number of administrative units, the need for the continuous improvement in the electoral process, and the high cost of living, which has pushed the cost of goods.
The factors for the significant increase and the cost drivers are indicated and include the projected increase in the voter population and hence the number of polling stations, an increase in the number of elected offices and number of candidates nominated for elections, an increase in the number of administrative units, as well as continuous improvements or reforms the
process. Byabakama made a passionate appeal to the government to ensure a timely release of its funds so that their activities can smoothly flow as planned. However, Byabakama cautioned political parties and organizations that the release of his plans does not mean that the country should engage in a frenzy of campaign-related activities.
That the release of this strategic plan and roadmap is not a license to throw the country into a frenzy of campaign-related activities for aspiring individuals, political parties, and organizations. While consultations are provided for in the law, campaigns must follow a program approved and regulated by the Commission.
The Prime Minister, Robin Nabanja, who officiated at the function, commended the Electoral Commission officials for the timely release of a roadmap, arguing that it's a clear signal that there will be peaceful elections come 2026. She, however, observed that they are still constrained by the delayed electoral reforms.
We have come up with a very good roadmap. I've also taken trouble. They sent me a book earlier, and I have pursued the plan and the roadmap. To me, I am satisfied that the strategy was given detailed attention and clearly outlines approaches the Commission will use in delivery of its constitutional mandate.
Nabanja challenged the Electoral Commission officials to intensify voter education outreach, especially to the youth, the elderly, and the people with disabilities.
I wish to request the leadership management of the Commission to continue engaging with all stakeholders as we implement this plan. I also wish to inform the Commission that the government of Uganda is ready to work with me so that this plan.
The Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao, called for unity come 2026 with an argument that political divisions will only make the country lag behind.
The big picture is that we need a united, democratic, prosperous and peaceful country. And some of us, right Honorable Prime Minister, as you know, have taken decisions to move together with you and the government that we serve, so that we keep this country together. Ultimately, there's no winner when there is chaos.
The objectives of the strategic plan include enhancing citizen participation, strengthening stakeholder collaboration and engagement, delivering free and fair elections and referenda, improving information sharing, public trust and confidence in the electoral process, and strengthening the capacity of the Electoral Commission. The plan also includes specific goals, activities, budget estimates, and time frames to guide the preparation for the 2025-2026 general elections. It is now crucial for all stakeholders to start planning and working towards the goals outlined in the roadmap. Story filed by Jared Namoya for the news.